My name is Sharon Akabas.
And my name is Eleanor Sterling.
And together we teach food, ecology, and globalization.
The point of the course is to really introduce students to how do we produce food, how do we market food, how do we use food, and how do we dispose of food, and the various choices that go into all along that trajectory. We redesigned the course to take into account the varied background of the students, but also try to think through ways we could better represent food systems and choices around foods in a systems perspective.
We wanted everyone to improve in terms of their critical thinking skills and their ability to assess claims and evaluate evidence. We did more flipping of the classroom where the students had things that they had to do that were preparatory so that we didn't have to do as much frontal lecturing. And when they came into the class, we worked in small groups. We did a few things. When we composed the group, we tried to emphasize the fact that we all have gifts and many of them are different from one another. And the more varied the gifts in the group, the better the outcome of the group. Many of the classes had opportunities for them to work together and understand things at a deeper level. And for the final assignment, which was heavily, heavily group-based, we had frequent check-ins to make sure that the dynamics of the group were working okay.
One example of a task-oriented product that we came up with for one of the classes is that we had the students read something on a study about the environment and then be ready to respond to a journalist about whether they agreed with the study or not. This models what I do as a professional. And then we did what's called a snowball, which is to take that two and then pair those two with two others and create a bigger group that then thinks it through and then a bigger group. And finally, when we got to the eight, we said to the group of eight, you have to come up with a consensus, the statement for the journalist.
The kinds of things we learned through this redesign and through working with CTL in general were invaluable. And I think that the resources that they offer to all of the faculty, so if you we're thinking about what are the lessons learned for other faculties to take advantage of the tremendous expertise and resources within CTL.
Yes, we participated in the Active Learning Institute that the CTL put together. By the end of the couple-hour period of the Learning Institute, we'd actually mapped out the entire course and really thought about flow and different parts of the courses and how they fit with each other, and it was hugely inspirational and not something I think we'd done in the past, and it really helped us a lot. So we really benefited from the Active Learning Institute and from working with CTL in general.